Here we'll look at the formula for elastic potential energy stored in a spring. If you compress or stretch a spring past its equilibrium point, then you can store energy in that spring. X stands for the displacement of the spring from its equilibrium position. And K stands for a spring constant, which is sometimes called a stiffness constant for the spring because it's related to how much force is required in order to get that spring to stretch. There's a graph of force applied versus displacement shown here for two springs. And this first question asks us, what is the spring constant of spring 2? So typically when we're doing this calculation, we want to identify two points on the graph that we want to use to calculate the spring constant. And when you have F versus delta X, then your slope becomes that K value, that spring constant. So we just have to get the slope of the line. And we can calculate it here using a triangle approach where we have a delta F and a delta X. We just want to divide them two. So looks like K will be eight newtons over 1 meter, which is 8 newtons per meter. And the units of the spring constant are newtons per meter, which tells you how much force is required to get this spring to stretch 1 meter. Okay, number two says, how much elastic potential energy would be stored in spring two if it were stretched from 0 to 0.4 meters. So talking about the displacement there, where 0 is the equilibrium. So for that, we're going to use the formula for elastic potential energy. It's a U with an E. U stands for potential energy, and then the E, just a little notation to let us know that it's for elastic problems. In elastic situations. So formula says 1/2 kx squared. So we're going to want to put the k in that we had found. And let's use our final x, 0.40. Okay, comes out to 0.64 joules. This next one says, how much additional energy would be stored in spring 2 if you stretch it from 0.4 to 0.8? Well, now we're talking about a change in elastic potential energy, so we're going to want to do UE final minus UE initial. And the final will be given by 1/2, 8 newton per meter, 0.8 squared. Okay, but we're going to want to now subtract the initial amount of energy that had already been stored in the spring. So when it was at 0.4, we said here that you got 0.64 joules stored. But if you go all the way to 0.8, then your spring has 2.56 joules stored. Okay, but we want to know what's the change from having 0.64 to 2.56. So we just want to subtract them two. It's 1.92 joules. Now, interestingly, graphically, if we were to look at this graph here, the area under the curve has meaning here. And when you're going from 0 to 0.4, talking about this area here, the area under the curve actually is the energy stored. And that's going to be the initial amount because we're going to 0.4. And so this little piece here, this trapezoid, would be the delta UE. That's what we're looking for. So the UE is 0.64 joules. That's just to get us from 0 to 0.4. Then once we get there, we need 1.92 more joules to stretch it from 0.4 to 0.8. And I have to put my mark down here, actually, not here. So the delta U is actually contained right in here. There we go. Okay. Last question. If spring 2 is stretched and held 0.8 meters beyond equilibrium, what will be the speed of the attached 5 kilogram mass when the spring's free end is released and it comes back to the equilibrium point? All right, so we know the energy stored in the spring. When it's held at 0.8 meters, it's got 2.56 joules. So by conservation of energy, when that block comes back to equilibrium point, how much kinetic energy is it going to have? 2.56 joules. So let K, that's the kinetic energy, not the spring constant, let it equal 2.56 joules. And then just set that 2.56 equal to the 1/2 mv squared. That's what we need. So 2.56 equals 1/2. Let's use the mass of the 5 kilograms. And let's see. Okay, and we want V squared. So we're going to solve for V. .01 meters per second.